Please take a moment to locate your nearest emergency exit, and out of respect for the artists on stage, as well as the other audience members, we ask that you turn off your cell phones now and refrain from texting during the show. As mandated by federal copyright law, any form of unauthorized recording or photography is strictly prohibited. Also, per JMU health and safety guidelines, all patrons must wear a mask when in the Forbes Center. There will be no intermission. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us today. You're all probably wondering, why in the world are we doing a concert on a Saturday at noon? It's not your typical time. Normally, this would be the day that JMU would be hosting the VBODA All Virginia Band and Orchestra auditions. So normally, we would have a little over 1,000 of Virginia's most talented high school musicians here on campus. Unfortunately, due to COVID, those auditions went virtual this year. So we had to do our concert, so we're still doing it. So here we are, and I think you're in for a treat. These guys are playing great, and we have a wide variety of music for you today. The first piece we're gonna play is by a Puerto Rican composer, Roberto Sierra. This is the first movement from his larger symphony, and the symphony subtitle is the Salsa. So you can imagine that there's gonna be a Latin feel to it. He describes this music as the Spanish-speaking Caribbean. Mainly, he's referring to Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, and Cuba. And of course, he has melded those folk feelings of Latin music with the modern concert hall. So it's a very complex piece based in that idea. So here is Sierra's Symphony No. 3, La Salsa, first movement.
Thank you. Thank you. this when he was a plucky 17-year-old young man. It's based off of My Country Tis of Thee, and so there's some tongue-in-cheek, you know, musical humor that you'll hear. You'll hear that very common melody played distinctively different styles throughout, and you can imagine, knowing, you know, his age, why he would have found this to be fun. And it's a fun piece to play, and I hope you enjoy it. Ironically, Ives ended up making a great deal of money doing not music, but being in insurance. So he was able to use his music as a way to just have fun without worrying about having to publish and make his living off it, which allowed him to have quite a bit of personality, which I think you'll hear. Please enjoy Variations on America.
Thank you. Thank you.
You might not know yet, but I encourage you to, when you go home, look him up. Carlos Simon, I think, is an amazing talent. He's young, he's only in his mid-30s, but he's already made quite a name for himself. In fact, he is the composer in residence with the National Symphony Orchestra this year. Most of his music is orchestral, but he does have a couple of pieces for wind band, one called Amen, and this one that he just wrote kind of right before COVID hit. So it hasn't, it didn't get a chance to get played much right off the bat, but lately it's been played a lot all over the country. As you can imagine by the title, it's based on the spiritual Sweet Chariot, but it's also combined with a Gregorian chant. If, I don't know if you had a chance to read the program notes, but Sweet Chariot is really about death. So he borrowed a Gregorian chant from the Mass, from the Latin Mass, and kind of combined the two. So if you're expecting a straight-ahead rendition of the melody Sweet Chariot, you're not going to get that. But listen carefully. You're going to hear how he combines these two melodies. And if you think about the opening motive of the tune Sweet Chariot, keep listening for that theme as it kind of reappears. But it's a very colorful piece with unique orchestration. Check out Carlos Simon. joining us today, and thank you to all the people that are out there in cyberspace tuning in via the internet. Thank you for joining us today. The next piece really needs no introduction. I think everybody knows this piece. But before I do that, I want to mention one other thing. The next concert that we'll be doing is a combined concert with the Wind Symphony and the Symphony Band. And it's our annual composers concert, and it's really a special event that has grown and become one of my favorite things of the year. I got together with our composition faculty, and we created kind of a little in-house composition contest with our students here. And so we've guaranteed that the Wind Symphony and probably the Symphonic Band will play the winning compositions. So on our April 6th concert, we'll be doing world premieres. This group will be doing Jack Yagerling's piece, and the Symphonic Band will be doing a piece by Joe Jackson. So those are our two student composers. We also have bring in a guest composer, and this year it's going to be Michael Markowski. And Wind Symphony will be playing his City Trees, and Symphonic Band will be playing his Saturn Returns. And we have an extra special treat this year that Eric Ginnivan, our composer here on campus, has written a great piece, and he did it years ago with the JMU Brass Band. Hopefully you were here to hear the great performance that they did last night, not on this piece, but they played this piece, I think, back in 2016 or 17, and Eric has made a version for it for Wind Band, and that piece recently won one of the big contests in the Wind Band composition world, so we thought we would jump on that bandwagon and champion that piece. We're very excited to premiere the wind version